Right, gonna quickly strip down this car because I need to get the motor out so we can change the spur gear and the sprocket and also see what's going on with the steering because it's not quite working properly and just see what else we can find. Okay, so now we should be able to get the motor out. So there we go, that's the whole assembly for the spur gear and the motor. So hopefully I can get those new bits ordered and then we can put them on. Mm. Now I need an Allen key to take off these cups either side to get into the sprocket. Bearing seems alright on that. No problems there. On this side, what's the bearing like on this side? It's actually still stuck inside there, you can see it's still stuck in there. Just get a screwdriver or something and just push it out. No, that bearing seems pretty good as well. Yeah. Right, now to get the sprocket off the motor, or the pinion rather, get the pinion off the motor, you just loosen the little grub in there, little grub screw, just undo that, then use a screwdriver just to prise that off there. Quite stiff. Here we go. So we're ready to have a new one put on. Right, it's already got the car stripped down to this stage. What I'm going to do is going to take off the steering arms here and also probably take the shocks off, because I'm sure the shocks probably need re-oiling, so take them off. Take this off here and might look inside the diffs to see what they look like inside. Okay. That's the whole front assembly off for the steering and the suspension, so that all comes completely off the chassis. We just need to get these off here. Thank you. Looks like they just used a cable tie because they didn't have a replacement screw. Looks like the screw obviously worked out. So it looks like I could probably just put a new screw in this and this probably reconnect up fine. I'll take this one out to have a look. I can put this in the other side to see if it actually still screws up okay. Then I just need to get a replacement screw instead of getting a new servo saver. That still holds fine, so that saved me a bit of money. Haven't got to buy a new one of those. So, brilliant. Right, what I'm going to do now is just take the shocks off, front and back. This one seems a lot better than that one. Seems more, there's more compression and it springs back a lot better than what this one does. So we'll open this one up, just take the top off and just see how much oil it's actually got inside. As you can see, it is a little bit low. Should be filled probably near enough to the top. Should be a little bit of a gap for air, but there isn't that much in there. What I'll do is I'll probably do those in another video, put another video up just showing how to refill these. And also I'll probably save another video for actually opening these diffs up and just having a little look inside to see if they need more grease or oil, see how much wear they have inside, because we've yet to run the car properly. So I don't really know how they're going to perform, but they seem to sort of turn okay. So what I'll do is I'll get a new pinion ordered, I'll get a new spare gear, and when they come in we can look into putting it all back together. Okay.